Good evening. So tonight we have a TV again, a Sinotec TV that apparently has no backlight. I've not checked this. LED in the bottom. Let's just press it. It goes to green. And I don't see any display. Let's take the torch. Let's see if we can. Anything? Let me turn off the top light and see if that makes a change to that. The light is still on. Difficult to see, but this little image on the screen, so it's definitely another backlight problem. So let's get the light back on and turn the TV back on its face, and then we can take it apart. So was taken apart before, as you can see, it's missing. So let me get you set up for the next shot and start removing the screws. Okay, sorry for the weird angle, but that's the easiest way I can show you guys what I'm doing. So I'm removing the stand screws. To two screws. So these are screws that goes into metal, these screws goes into plastic. just a reminder that these TV do have high voltage in them, so be cautious of that. That should be all the screws. There could be voltage on this cap, so don't touch that cap. This speaker's on rubber mounts. There's a clip over here. Can we move the power lead? And we can remove this whole back port. Just set this to the side. Of course, you're going to need to take the panel out. So, I don't see any plastic clips like the other one I did. So, we must probably just leave that in place. So what we need to do is to remove this clip over here and release this ribbon cable, and that should be it. So the sensitive parts are these little ribbon cables here, and this board should come with the LCD together, so we'll have to remove the speakers and just take it out like that. And this board is quite nice because it's got some screws. Not like the other JVC we did, which just have adhesive on the back. Let's see if we can get the screws. Alright, so that's loose. So let me get you set up again. And we're going to start removing the plastic frame all over. So we need to do lift up the TV and the corners are normally the most difficult part to release. The center parts looks much easier. Yeah. Took this speaker back in. You guys can see that. So what I'm doing is releasing all the clips. Top. The corners are the difficult part. Since you get one corner, it becomes easy. So what I do is TV flat down. Start removing the plastic trim. It's coming off. Stubborn clip left here. Come on. Okay. So don't remove your finger. Fingers holding the LCD in place. If you remove your finger, LCD will fall out. So what we can do is the LCD flat, put the TV flat down again, flip this board over, the green board in the bottom, and let's lift the TV off from the rest of the TV. That's the LCD panel. So let's pick this up. And another thing I have to be careful is there's this little green stuff there. That's a little chip on there, and that chip, if you damage it, you have vertical, horizontal lines going across the screen this way. Let's get back to this board. So this is another plastic frame. We'll have to unclip this as well. This just clips out. Sometimes you need to encourage it a little bit. I missed one here. when you get one or two sides off, it becomes very flimsy. Get that out of the way. Okay, then we get the diffuser layers. I just take them all off at one time. And I try not to mix them up. Because they are important in layers. And there's different layers. There's different layers for different applications. So these ones are screwed down. Let's get these screws out. I'll say this Sinotec looks like a better build than a JVC. I'm quite surprised. So I'm guessing we still got one big LED on one of these backlight strips. Problem in repairing TVs is you need quite a big space to do it. Especially getting to the 65-inch TVs. Alright, so that's the diffuser. And we are left with three backlights. So, I'm going to unplug these three strips. And let's get a meter. So, this is the little clips, the little wires I was talking about. 1, 2, 3. So let's get them out and get this out of the way and we could just concentrate on that strips. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is switch off the top light, set the multimeter to diode mode. Yeah, and we'll have a better view of the LEDs. So I've got a red probe on the positive and a black probe on the negative, and you can see that LED is working. So let's put a mark over there. Let's do the next one. That was quite good. It's quite bright in the camera. This one is right. Next one. This one is working. So we're hunting down one for the LED. Because all of these LEDs are in series. So I'm going to beat the strip most probably, and then I'm going to eat my words after this. negative is on all the way on the other side. Positive there. This strip is completely working. Do the next one. Start with a difficult one. One shot. So, we can do a close up of this. So, there's a positive, right? And here's the negative for that LED. All the others, it's got positive and negative right next to the LED. It makes it quite easy to test these strips. Gonna take a guess, it's gonna be in the top strip. This is wrong. This one was working. This one was not working. This one was working. That one was working. That one was working. That one was working. Let's just try this one again. So for the LED over there, let's do this difficult one first again. So this whole strip is working, and we found our faulty LED. So let's get to the bench, remove this cover, replace the LED, put everything back together again. Working TV again. Okay, so we're on the workbench. Let's remove that lens off the LED. I can just grip this. Came off, and you can actually see a black spot in that LED. Let's focus closer. As you can see, there's definitely a little black spot in that LED. Let's focus back down. There we go. Alright, so what we need to do. Get the soldering iron on, get the heat on. You can apply some flux. Do this LED. Get the tweezer handy. Get the solder handy. So they use lead 3 solder on these LEDs. So Okay. That was easy enough. That little LED is off. So let's get the replacement one. I just take them off old LED strips. Same story, strip it. That one doesn't want to come off, let's try another one. I'm more worried about the LED on this one than the lens. That's not coming off. The next possible one is this little screwdriver. There we go. Now these I know doesn't come that easy off like we did that one. And you also can see this LED must be turned around to fit on that board. So let's just add a little bit of solder to the LED. Make it a bit easier. And then what I normally do see if I can show you this. The LED hanging off the table. I'll take off this station, put it underneath. I don't want to directly heat the LED because sometimes it will melt. First station set to about 370. This will take a while. Let's try using the iron solder to heat up the pads. Go slightly hotter with the hot air station. Come on, there we go. LED is removed. Now you will see one pad is bigger than the other. The bigger pad is the negative one. see. This pad is bigger than that pad. This is the negative side, that's the positive side of the LED. They don't always work that way. Sometimes they are the other way around. There we go. You see the bottom of the LED as well. The pad is bigger than the other one. So this LED focus back down there. Should go this way around. So what we do now, remove this one off the board. Let's put this over here. Seat up the strip. This should go easier because of the leaded solder. There we go. Just gonna that's in place. You can switch off the hot air. You can switch off the soldering iron. We're done with those. Just let it cool down. Let's move back over to the table. This will take a while to cool down because of the this whole strip is like a heatsink for the LEDs as well. That's why they screw down to the metal plate. Just found my alcohol. Alright, it should be good enough. Let's soak this area with a bit of alcohol or IPA. Isopropyl alcohol, and we can clean this LED off nicely, remove all the flux. I know some people just put a wire, you can do that. The problem is for every LED you remove, you increase the current to the other LEDs, which will eventually kill them all. So I just prefer to put another LED in its place. So I'm just going to get a meter quickly and let's test that LED. So the meter's in diode mode, red one there, black one there, and we have a LED that's lit up perfectly. So all we need to do is reattach the lens and that should be the fix for this one. So let me get the glue quickly and then we can do that. I just use these stuff. I actually use it to glue cell phone backs to the glass of the cell phone in the back covers. You'll feel that normally sit in place. Just hold it a few seconds there. I think this takes quite a while to cure. Alright, that sits like that. This glue does take a while to clear properly, but you're not gonna run around quickly, so I'm gonna leave it for a few, say 10 minutes or so, and then we'll put it back in the TV, hook everything up, and give it a test. Alright, so we're back here. Got the three LED strips. So let's get the TV back on. There we go. The strips back in and clip them in their places. Doesn't matter which one goes where, all three are all the same LED strips. Got them back into the screws. Let's install the reflector back in, and now we need to put all the screws back in. Gonna do one on each line first so that they can't move around on us. I actually prefer this design versus the other one, JVC, that we did in a previous video. I think this got a much better way of doing it. I'm just doing this corner here. I'll just move this up a little bit. You could buy LED kits or these strips. You can find them on eBay and all those other places. Three left. You can install the diffuser plates, and then the LCD goes back. Right, let's get you guys a bit higher and then we can see more of what I'm doing. We go. We got most of the TV in there. fuses that goes back. Got little hooks that they go into. Yeah. All right, it's all set nicely. Make sure there's no dust or anything on there. Let's get the first plastic bracket in. Make sure this it's all nice and flush. Slight corner that's bent there. It's normal. All right, so that's all in. So next thing, we can put the LCD in. So let's get the LCD. And make sure it sits in its groove all around. If it's sticking up in one corner and you put the top bezel back, you will crack the LCD. So this is the last bezel that goes on. Careful of the board in the bottom. Let's move it this way. Put my hand in there to clip it in. There we go. Let's lift this up. It's all clipped back together. Let's slowly move the TV around. And get this board screwed back in place. If it's two little screws, started. One on the other corner. This ribbon cable back into place. Make sure it's nice and flat. There we go. Speakers are next. Let's push them in. Leave for that until we put the plate back. So I'm going to move you guys around again so I can assemble the bottom part of this. Okay, so assembly the bottom part. Right, so let's assemble this bottom part. Let's plug this plug in first back. Goes over there into those clips. And then we can put the speaker back. Yeah. We have to do the power. Clips in there. This bottom cover back. Clips in the bottom. Walls align again, just do one screw over here. Let's give it a test. Let's plug in. Switch it on. We have backlight. We have the screen there in the bottom. It shows AV. And here we have our no signal. So, switch it off. Let's finish the assembly. Let's move it a little bit more to this side. And a little bit more down. Smaller screws for here. This one was for here. three top ones. And the last one. Oops, last one. Wrong place. Right, let's. Through this. We have the reversible. And you can go all the way back. For this little thing here, and this is left. This way. Yeah, get the click. It's a hell of a TV as well. And a little screw. Get you guys lower and switch it on, and we call that the fix. So, get you guys a bit lower. Right, switch it on. Backlight. The bar on the bottom, and we should have a no signal sign on the screen. There we go. So it's all done. Thanks for watching, and I'll give this a clean up. This TV was here before our lockdown started, which is about 3 months, and yeah, took a while. So thanks for watching, and see you in the next one. Cheers.